The COVID-19 pandemic has affected more than 200 countries in the world, with more than 1,130,000 infections and counting, ever since the disease was first discovered in Wuhan, China, in December 2019. Social distancing has become the buzzword of 2020, a term that we never thought would exist last year. Efforts to prevent the spread of virus across nations include quarantines, lockdowns, travel restrictions and border closure, and postponing of events. Someone once said, "We would be flying cars in 2020, instead we are back to the basics. Washing our hands properly. But remember, we do not have to lose sanity. In fact, this is the time we can defeat an enemy by staying isolated, instead of coming together." If you are feeling anxious or stressed out with the lockdown and being quarantined for an extended period of time, or if you are feeling paranoid about the coronavirus and its effects on you and your family, just chill. As long as you are listening and abiding by what your local health authority and government is asking you to do, practicing hygiene, washing your hands regularly, and practicing social distancing, you are safe. Here is how you can boost your mental health during this period. Do not bombard yourself with coronavirus news all the time. It can be distressing to hear the pandemic-related news every time you put your TV on and go on the web. Turn off news alerts because they can take your mind away from productive ideas and positive thoughts. Of course, you need to have access to credible information, so instead of taking news from WhatsApp forwards and gossip channels once or twice a day, just go to credible sources of information like the CDC, WHO or a reliable mainstream news channel for coronavirus-related news and updates. Social distancing also means great emotional bonding. Spend time with your family. The lockdown and quarantine period not only gives you an opportunity to vibe with your family members but also discover yourself. Use technology to stay in touch with friends, acquaintances and distant family members. Get in touch with that person you didn't get the chance to talk to for months. The lockdown period is also the time to increase your productivity and self-discipline yourself. Set written goals for the day and work on your plan. Stick to a schedule. Develop a hobby, work on things that develop your personality. There is a looming fear of job loss and late salaries because business productivity has been affected by COVID-19. When you work from home, be disciplined and show that you are a valuable force to your company. This is also the time to work on your dream, to analyze and plan that business move. This is the time to sharpen your skills, look out for online jobs, do a lot of reading, practice your skills and watch a lot of educational programs and skill-based tutorials in the field of your interest. Treat every day like a window of opportunity to enrich your mind and body. Strengthen your mind by reading a lot of personality development books, books on life skills, and even fascinating thrillers and stories that keep you rooted on what will happen next. This is the time to sharpen your creativity, your logical skills and your imaginative power. Play your favorite music, watch comedy shows, experiment with cooking, experiment with makeup, learn to play a musical instrument, write a book, clean that shelf, or dance your blues away. There is no limit to what you can do. Watch your favorite movies, enjoy those memes, and binge watch your favorite shows, but give precedence to activities that will develop your personality. Watch and read content that adds value to your personality and interpersonal relationships. Eat healthy, make sure that you have a balanced diet. Exercise daily, enjoy your workout sessions, to the tune of your favorite music blasting in the background. When you exercise, not only do you build your body and strengthen your mental health, your body also releases feel-good endorphins that put you in a zone of peak performance. Do not judge people or a section of society if it is being portrayed in the media that they were irresponsible and spread the virus. Let's face it, the blame game will never stop. As a responsible person, we should not jump to conclusion about who is responsible for the spread of the disease. If it has happened, it has happened. There is no point analyzing something that is not going to do us any good. Our priority is to ensure that we take safety precautions. Have an open communication with your children. Spend time with them, and dispel any doubt they may have about the virus and its spread. Talk to your partner, family members and friends about various other interesting things, not just about COVID-19. Infuse a lot of humor in your discussions, spread entertainment around, and stay positive. Lastly, do not overthink, focus on the present and use all your resources to make today a masterpiece. If you feel that you are not able to cope with stress, and feeling anxious or paranoid about the pandemic, and other issues in your life, contact your doctor, or your mental health specialist. Did you find this video helpful? If yes, please hit the like button. Subscribe to our channel for more videos like this, and press the bell icon for new videos.